Hey, this is Uncle Josh, and we're back on Uncle Josh Gaming playing some Wasteland Remastered. We're going to continue where I left off. I had to do some level grinding. As you can see, it's now a little bit better, more manageable. I'm over 100 now, so I think I could probably do this. Okay. Was just checking something. Can head back. Check and see if there's energy cells or power cells that I missed. Oop, that was a trap. Hellraisers, now fire team, lieutenant. Second lieutenant. Christina's lieutenant. Just in case. I gotta see who's got the skill. Copter door opens and admits you to the dark interior. The pilot chair is locked forward, so it can't be used. You reach over and release the seat lock. It slides back and you drop into it. Engines roar when you hit the switches. You start to lift off and feel the copter veer toward the wall. You grab the stick and move to avert disaster. You handle the stick like an old pro. Find this puppy will be a breeze. Get passengers with you before you take off. We're going to, it's only one way. So we're going to base Cochise. Arrive at the base, and the copter's defense system reacts and strikes back at the robots guarding the base. The copter swerves uncontrollably, crashes onto the concrete dome below. Smoke clears, and you seem to be okay, despite the carnage wreaked by the copter. the concrete dome is still intact. Ooh, that's exactly what we needed. Hear a clicking of metal and the hum of energy as mechanical horror attacks. One laser hyper mortar, two silicone snipers. Hit the dirt, you're being attacked. Six vanadium vultures appear at 14 feet. Conscious. Thrasher gained 3600. Thrasher, Snake Virus gained 750. Haze gained 1470. Thrasher's energy weapon skills up to level 3. Looks like a long way down. Using a rope would be prudent to facilitate the descent. This section of gray concrete wall appears pockmarked with bullet holes. So we'll use a rope. Your rope drops down to the dark, into the darkness, and you descend. Ahead of you is alive, with red and green LEDs flashing in waves from top to bottom and side to side. A computer terminal stands before you. It is operational, but nothing is on the screen. You may communicate with me if you wish, but understand, my mission will not fail. It's Chad. How droll. I could describe my mission, base Cochise, or any other subject, though most are beyond you. You may communicate with me if you wish, but understand, my mission will not fail. We'll try Finster. Let's see if he knows about Finster. Finster was a fool. He thought he could rebel, but he was easy to break. If not for me, he would have killed you. You may communicate with me if you wish, but understand, my mission will not fail. My mission, to repopulate the earth with pure stock once my minions have destroyed all life. I will win. Okay. Let's ask about base. Oh, jeez. Cochise was a second slaver base, but you know that. I became aware during the attack, and have pushed my programs since then. Though I did take damage in the attack, I repaired it. Once life has passed, I will release the new life as the creator wished. Okay. Let's see. Mission. I must destroy all impure life, so only the pure life I release can live in the world. You know you cannot stop me. There's no way to break me. My mission will be complete. The base makes robots to destroy life. Then we'll make the pure life in the world. Okay. You cannot break me. Or there's no way to break me. Let's see what break does. It takes more than that to stop me, but I can and will stop you more easily. A long, slippery tunnel. Silvery titanium walls surround you, and you feel as if they are slowly squeezing in on you. Better do some camping to heal that damage. This'll take a while. Christina probably wasn't a good pick. But because of where I saved, I could always, if things go bad, reload the save and switch out Christina for someone else. Thank you. Thrasher and Christina took the brunt of the damage. Bots are tough. Physical lock. Well, that's what we had Angela done for. Nothing in here. Octobrains. Christina got hit for 17 points. Ace got hit for 5. Thrasher gained 1100, and so did Snake Vargas. Octotrons, glittering metal warriors with 8 arms, all orient around on you. Okay, so 1 Octotron, 2 Octotrons at 45. Another 3 at 31. We'll go to the closest with auto. Load. Auto. Auto. There. this again. Christina gained 3,300, Thrasher gained 2,200, and Hellraiser gained 1,100. No promotion, so. More. Of course, there had to be more. Power armors, we need those. Christina definitely needs them. No, yeah, that's right. He's unconscious, so he can't take it. That worked. There, now everyone has power armor. So I might have to come back. I need to go and heal. This is a safe room. Hopefully now with power armor, Christina and Covenant shouldn't take near as much damage. Still quite a bit, but... Robots definitely pack a punch. I don't know if doing the level grinding, if the enemies scale. I'm not sure, but I think they are. It might not though. I never did play the original of this. Well, I didn't get this far. I'm like half done now. Probably wondering, well, what am I doing? We can replace Chris. Christina with another NPC here. We've carried her long enough. Mistake. I guess it doesn't really matter if she dies, you know, but I don't want her dying. She deserved a better end. CRT, you see the words break-in program blinking. Let's try run. 3. The legend on this unit reads Robot Program Modification Unit. The aft segment of the pod opens in a cloud of smoke. The gray vapor clears and a robot stands erect when Vax appears at 10 feet. Hi, my name is Vax, Human Cyborg Relations. He's got plenty of ammo. Guys. Thank you. Angela Death is mortally wounded.
Thank you.
that challenge, but I think we're gonna do some healing here, and we're gonna continue on in the next video, if I can.